All of a sudden, Senator Mitt Romney, a Republican from the state of Utah, has decided to speak out against his own party and specifically call them out over how they use the reconciliation process to pass massive tax cuts for the rich under the Trump administration. Now, it's important to point that out because now all of a sudden Republicans are pretending like they're worried about the national debt and the deficit. But Romney here, in a moment of clarity, speaks the truth. Let's listen.
There's no question that if you begin doing things which break a precedent or break tradition, that the other side is going to do that when they're in charge. And so when we put through a this was before my time in the Senate, but when we put through a tax program on a basis that did not require any Democrat votes, done through reconciliation, why? We have a difficult time explaining why we're not happy with what they would be doing at this stage. There's no question about that. Same thing with regards to our debt. I mean, during the time when the economy was booming and we had a Republican president and House and Senate, we kept on spending massively more than we were taking in, almost $1 trillion a year in deficit spending every year, adding to the national debt, almost $1 trillion a year. So now we say, this is outrageous, you're adding to the debt. And they say, hey, where were you when you were in charge? You did the same thing. So yeah, I mean, it does show you that you have to be somewhat consistent, or your arguments when the other side acts out of a character that you think is inappropriate, why you don't have much grounding for your argument.
So Senator Mitt Romney, a Republican, agrees with Representative Jamal Bowman, a progressive in the House, who also tweeted that Republicans are only concerned about the deficit when we're trying to help working people. They had no problem running up the deficit to give massive tax breaks to the rich and corporations. This is exactly why we can't take them or their deficit concerns seriously. And of course, I agree with him on that. And keep in mind that the tax cuts for the rich cost the US economy $2 trillion over the over 10 years. So it clearly is not something that Republicans were concerned about early on. And now when it comes to nickel and diming the American people, they pretend like they care about the deficit. So Nando, I know that you've been kind of happy to hear that some of these more neoliberal Democrats are kind of moving away from being concerned about the deficit. Do you want to talk about that a little bit?
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think that that's been a sea change, I think, in liberal politics, that that there's been kind of an emancipation of deficit fears, which was, you know, the Obama administration was riddled with people who were obsessed with the deficit, and Obama himself was obsessed with the deficit. I mean, he was a big fan of that Simpson-Bowles commission, which every single nerd in Washington was obsessed with back in like 2012, 2013, that wanted to cut a grand bargain to slash Social Security. The thing about Mitt Romney and the difference between his point and what Jamal Bowman is saying is, like, they're kind of saying the same thing, but it's actually very different. Is that Mitt Romney like wants to reduce the deficit by slashing public services. He's fine with the tax cuts for corporations and the wealthy. He just thinks that we should just keep cutting public services. He doesn't think we should increase public services or even maintain them at the levels that they are right now. So I just, when there's been a certain kind of like liberal reaction to Mitt Romney, which reminds me a lot of the liberal reaction to John McCain, and Mitt Romney is sort of very self-consciously filling that John McCain spot of the Republican that liberals are obsessed with. And because he says a few things that are that seem like an apostasy to his own party, they're obsessed with him. In a way that Republicans are never obsessed with any Democrat that breaks with their party. Like, what Republican is obsessed with Kristen Sinema? You know, like, they don't give any crap about Kristen Sinema, you know,
or Manchin.
Whereas like liberals like love Mitt Romney. Like, I saw people calling him a national hero because he was like, you know, saying that Trump's claims about the election fraud were baseless or whatever. It's like, that's such a low bar. It's like the lowest bar ever. That does not make you a national hero. Mitt Romney was basically the guy who invented the private equity industry in the 1970s. He was instrumental in inventing that industry, which has wrought untold damage on the American people. Bain Capital is like an evil corporation, like in ways that are almost unimaginable. So I don't know. Mitt Romney says every once in a while a few things that aren't like frothing at the mouth Republican propaganda. I don't know. I find it hard to. My body can't say like good job, Mitt Romney. Those words cannot come out of my mouth. It's like that scene in Liar Liar when he's like trying to do the pen is blue. You know, I can't do it. I just can't. The words cannot come out of my mouth.
Remember when Mitt Romney was running against Obama in 2012? He really took a giant hit in polling when he had. When he unwittingly was saying some pretty negative things about poor working people in America, right? So you're absolutely right.
It was
right,
his version of the deplorables comment. The same thing.
Exactly. Yeah. And don't. It's a little different because with Hillary Clinton, and I'm not trying to like make excuses for her, but it was more about like some of the pretty disgusting rhetoric meant to divide the country coming from these people. But in the case of Romney, there was this very clear disdain for working people in America. Yeah. And it was just so clear that it did like hit him in the polls pretty hard. So there's obviously, I don't want anyone to think that I've forgotten who Mitt Romney is. However, I think that when Republican lawmakers make statements like this, you're right that liberals obsess over it, but they never really use it to their advantage. Like, I'm gonna snip that out and put it in my back pocket and I'm ready to go. Like, I'm ready with political ads and I'm gonna, you know, use Romney against his own party. That's what I think about. Like, that's how my mind works when I hear him making those kinds of statements. And so I just think that, you know, in terms of campaigning and time, in terms of political ads, they just need to be a lot savvier and really capitalize off of moments like this, which I think that they've really failed to do. Don't give him brownie points without being able to actually use his words against the Republican Party.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.